Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about my ferret cleaning guide, my top tips and tricks on how to keep a home smelling nice if you have ferrets. Before I start the video, do not forget to check out my merch store. I actually have a discount running up until January 8th. If you apply the code New Year, I don't know if it has to be in caps or not, you can get 10% off of anything that you order on the store, whether it be a hoodie or my brand new book. And don't forget to subscribe and comment if you like this video. My apologies for like the weird lighting situation. It's a nice day outside, but it's really, really dark and gloomy. I had to work with what I got. But anyways, this was a recommendation by one of you guys. I'm not exactly sure who it was. I don't remember. You know who you are, and thank you for recommending this topic. I think it's really important. For those of us who do have ferrets or who know people who have ferrets, when you walk into a house with ferrets, you can generally smell them. They have a smell to them. And firstly, I wanted to discuss how dirty ferrets actually are, because they do obviously have the stereotype that follows them that ferrets are stinky, smelly, kind of gross little creatures, and that's not necessarily the case, and it doesn't have to be as well. They themselves do create oils all over their body, and I have a great kind of gross example of this. One of my baby gates that I have in my house that the ferrets used to slip in and out of, the areas where they have been going in and out of, you can see a buildup of just their oils from just the top of their coats going through the baby gate. So that's kind of gross, but a good example of their oil that they have that they produce all over their body. And I'm asked a lot how ferrets smell, like what do they smell like, and the best way that I can describe this is a mixture of body odor, like a smelly armpit, and like a musty old attic. Some ferrets also do have a bit of sweetness to their smell, mine do, and they also, like their hind ends kind of have an artificial grape scent. It's very, very weird, but a lot of ferrets also have that. And so I personally don't really mind the smell, especially because it has like those notes of sweetness to them. So do not go into getting ferrets and thinking that you're going to eliminate their odors completely, because that's not natural. That's not gonna happen. The best thing that we can do really is to just manage the smell in the most natural way possible, and that's what this video today is going to be about. As you may know, the answer to eliminating odors or to even minimizing them is to not bathe your ferrets. Bathing your ferrets will actually give you the opposite results, because once the oil from their bodies is stripped from them, generally by warm water or soap, the ferret's body goes into overdrive because they need those oils. It's part of their defense mechanism. It's part of the way that they mark their territory. It's just a natural part of their being. So once it's removed, their body is like, oh my gosh, we need to produce more. And I don't even bother bathing my ferrets with even oatmeal. I know I've done that in the past, done sort of like an oatmeal soak. I don't even do that anymore because it really doesn't do much for my ferrets. And if I'm doing something like that to treat a skin condition or a health concern, I have plenty other more natural methods to do that with. So the first tip that I have in managing odors with ferrets naturally is to feed a good diet. Naturally, when ferrets are fed a diet closest to their species, closest to what they have been built to consume, they are going to smell a little bit better. Their coats will be shinier, their breath will be cleaner, and a big one is their stool volume is going to be smaller, aka smaller poops, which is good for you and good for the members of your home. Fresh, raw diet free of fillers, processed ingredients, anything that ferrets cannot digest properly, you're going to get a naturally better smelling ferret in the end. And another thing to go along with that, an easy way of doing this at home, also minimizing smell, is to provide enough free roam. Kind of a bit of a no-brainer, but when you have your ferrets in a larger space, their smell doesn't really have the opportunity, hi Appa, to accumulate in one spot. It's less saturated or concentrated in one area. So if they have more areas to roam, the less smell you're going to get. You'll notice that if you go to the pet store or if you go to someone's house where they keep their ferrets caged for long periods of time, you're going to notice more of that smell, especially if they use things like rodent bedding or they're not really washing their stuff a lot. And that is kind of why they have that stereotype that follows them everywhere. So now we get into the actual cleaning and upkeep portion of this video. I have a couple products here that I'm going to be talking about, but first, remember to avoid artificial fragrances in the form of candles, wax melts, incense, plug-ins. These all mask the odors. It doesn't necessarily get rid of them. Your ferrets are not accustomed and equipped to process these potentially harmful chemicals that you're putting out into the air, and same goes for you as well. Using them once in a while probably isn't going to do much damage, but it's the chronic exposure to these potentially harm your ferrets in the long run. And certain essential oils have been noted to be toxic to small animals. Instead, our goal should be to get the space as clean as possible so that naturally it will deodorize itself rather than masking those issues. In my experience, ferret smell accumulates the most on whatever they're laying on, whether it be blankets, beds, pillows, soft toys, anything like that really absorbs their odors. So a good idea would be to add that to your weekly laundry list. And for this, I use hypoallergenic, fragrance-free detergent and dryer sheets. I don't use anything with fragrance. You can also make your own. I haven't tried that myself just yet. Or instead of using dryer sheets, you can hang up their items to dry outside in the sun, which I will touch more on in a little bit. Number two, pee pads in litter boxes can emit a lot of odor, so be sure to change them frequently. I personally use pee pads. It's a personal preference. I use them all around my house, and I do use unscented pee pads. Yes, there are scented pee pads out there. There's pretty much a scented version of anything. For litter, my favorite is recycled paper pellets. I do not personally like the smell of wood pellets. I think it makes my house smell like a shed or a wood shop, and I personally don't like that smell at all. I don't want to feel like I'm living in a barn, but I still don't use scented litters or litter powders that you add to the litter or anything like that. Now, as far as getting ferrets to actually use these items, because that's a whole other story, it can be hard. Ferrets want to go to the bathroom wherever they want to go. You can try to stop them, you can try to deter them. They are very determined creatures. They're not like dogs, who have a natural inclination to want to please you, and it's fairly easy to potty train a dog to go outside, or like a cat, who has that natural desire to use a litter box and to cover their poop and their pee. Ferrets don't have that. They're their own animal, and that is why it can be difficult to potty train them. I do have a couple videos on the channel on potty training, so go check that out. I do recommend doing it via positive reinforcement, but if you are free roaming your ferrets, which I really, really hope that you are, and in large areas, it's gonna be tough to get your ferrets to be 100% accurate on pee pads or litter boxes, and that's just something that you're gonna have to be okay with. So if you're renting and you have carpeted floors or anything like that, that's something that you're gonna want to consider before getting ferrets. So to clean up accidents, I have a couple different things that I do, but I don't use anything fancy, and everything that I use can be made at home easily. In my experience, ferret poop can sometimes stick to hard floor, and it can be difficult to get up if you don't notice it in time. So clean accidents as quickly as possible so it can't harden. A lot of times that happens with raw fed ferrets, their poop kind of hardens to the floor. And in those cases, really, really easy. I just do some soap, some basic unscented soap, and some warm water. I put it on a sponge, and then I squeeze it, gently squeeze it over the accident. And within a couple minutes, it will be easy to just clean up with a paper towel. And you can also choose to go back with a homemade vinegar and water mixture. I usually use white vinegar, not apple cider vinegar. I save this for other things that I make. And there are many recipes online that you can look up on how to make a vinegar water cleaner. I try not to use it on really big areas because in my experience on floors and stuff, it can be a little bit streaky, and I don't really like the feeling of the floor after I use it. And this method can also be used on carpets, but I have tried a lot of natural carpet cleaners to get out like really tough stains, especially when Gen was learning how to go to the bathroom outside when he was a little puppy. All my carpets are my own. They do not belong to the place that I'm renting, but they can be really tough to get out using natural methods. So in a lot of cases, I have needed to turn to more conventional products to get stains out. And that just kind of requires making sure the ferrets are away, air out the house, let it completely dry before you let your ferrets back on the carpet. But this is the, it's kind of gross, the nozzle's gross. This is the product that I've been using, just the Carbona Oxy-powered pet stain odor remover. This stuff is really, really strong. So this will get out most stains, at least in my experience. Normally, of course, I wouldn't use products such as this, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do to get those stains out. I have stopped using like baking soda to get odors out of carpets and then vacuuming them up because it does tend to degrade your vacuum over time when you do that. It's not really gentle on your vacuum. So instead I found that just vacuuming normally, getting on a schedule for that is good enough. You may need to rent or purchase a steam cleaner. If you have like thick, fluffy carpets though, I would recommend seeking out a professional as far as carpet cleaning goes to give you recommendations. Air purifiers do seem to work in a lot of cases to rid ferret odor. Make sure to do your research on the best products for small animals. I do not personally use one because I just haven't forked over the money for one, but I do know many people who use one and say that it's very efficient. Since I don't have one, on any day where it's like 50 degrees Fahrenheit or over like today, for example, I will open the windows, get some fresh air in, because fresh air really does a great job in just obviously airing out the home, but like removing the ferret odors. If you feed raw, be sure to clean up any stash areas every single day. Don't let that stuff sit because you can start attracting flies or ants and just that meat smell. Wash their toys often. Anything plastic or a similar material can be washed with soap and water in the sink. That's something that people forget to do. And their soft toys as well can accumulate those scents. Simmer pots can be used on occasion to help make the home smell better, though it is a short-term solution and it does, again, mask those odors that are already there. I've done this once before when I was gonna have guests over, and I did notice a little bit of a difference, but it wasn't super strong. It didn't really cover the whole home. It was very concentrated in the area that I was making it, like the kitchen, and it didn't last for very long. You would be surprised the amount of hair that comes off these little ferrets, especially during shedding season. Oh my gosh. When I vacuum, I always like look to see how much hair I actually collected because it's so satisfying, and it's a lot. Hair and dander can have their oils on them, so you're gonna wanna try to remove those. I vacuum a few times a week and that does really help. I also use like the little tools that are on it to get into the crevices and anywhere that I can't really reach very well. And on that same note, brush your ferrets often. This will help distribute their oils a little bit better so they're not so concentrated on them, and it will remove those hairs before they end up on your couch or your carpet. The next tip I have here, I haven't actually tried yet, but I will after this video, and that is apparently apples are very good at absorbing odors. So a lot of people have recommended online to just slice an apple in half and leave it in a room or an area where the odor have been accumulating, and it will absorb odors for up to 6 hours. That's pretty crazy, but I have yet to try that. So if that's something that you've tried after this video or before this video, please let me know down below if that worked for you. And then lastly, I have sunlight is a natural deodorizer, and one of the reasons why many people like to dry their clothes outside in the sun, because it really helps get rid of any excess odors that are left on the clothing and the sheets. And so if you do have a really sunny day, I would recommend after washing your ferret's bedding to hang it out either after drying or during the drying process to dry out in the sun. I used to do this a lot in my old apartment when I didn't have access to a washer or a dryer. I would hand wash their items and then dry them outside, and it did really help. Certain materials though, if you're gonna dry completely outside, have a tough time drying, such as fleece, I've noticed, any like thick fabrics. But if you have like linen, similar materials, those dry really well outside. So that is all of my tips and tricks. I'm sure I missed a couple. Make sure to leave below anything that you do that works well at minimizing odors. Please consider becoming a member on the channel. It really helps support my content here. And I will see you guys in my next video.